Hi, my name is Luc Andrieux. I am the writer-director of Agoria, Call of the Wild. This film introduces a new female hero eye concept, Jane, an enigmatic LAP rookie trapped into a scary police-season ritual and forced to face a secret power to dive into death. For years now, I am developing a strong visual identity based on the use of classical tools like dolly, slider or crane, avoiding handheld and steadicam as much as possible. Every project I write and direct is a way for me to experience a new field of storytelling, not only on a visual standpoint, but also on a subconscious standpoint.
They are your tools.
Growing as a writer, you tend to tell a story through the angle of certain characters. Therefore, it becomes more interesting if the audience feels like the main character point of view might be unreliable due to her drug habits, mental state, or psychological trauma. Call of the Wild was the first film in which I decided to frame handheld sequences. It sounded to me like the best visual storytelling tool for the interiors of the house. Los Angeles is not an easy area to shoot an ambitious project with a low budget. You must pay thousands of expensive permits. A single gunshot will cost you $200 to rent the gun, $900 to pay the weapon supervisor, plus $3,000 to pay the permit to shoot by night in a Sodom. I tend to explore the documentary style using extreme close-ups on newspaper headlines. Jane is a fascinating character for me to keep on exploring the thin line between real life and dreamlike perception. My producer, Pierre Cazenave from Solda Film, triggered the whole project by introducing me to the amazing electronic music artist Agoria, Sébastien Dehaut. It was an exciting experience to collaborate with Agoria as he reworked his track through the editing process of the video by adding powerful instrumental parts. Agoria's inputs were priceless in terms of balance between the music video and the narrative segments. Call of the Wild is a female of fear for men. Death is the ultimate Pandora's box. Dealing with it calls us to face inherent fears over the unknown. Jane breaks these boundaries and unveils the mysteries of the antechamber of death. The thin line between what the audience's eyes should consider as reality or should perceive as the product of character's imagination opens an amazing space of storytelling levels. This pattern allows me to even speculate with the audience on the reliability of Jane's ultimate power. In fact, you should experience this music video as a proof of concept for a full-length movie called Lifeline.
It's like a bad dream. You want to wake up, but you can't do it.